Hi, and welcome to my introduction video on my series on using markers within Logic Pro and Mainstage. And just to give you an idea of what I'm going to be covering in that series, I'll focus on two different components. One will be a Logic component, and then the other will be Mainstage. And within Logic, I'll show you what a marker track is. And this is a marker track. And what I will then do is show you how to create these different markers, move them, rename them, color them, and then at the same time use these markers as not only visual markers within your project, but then how to quickly navigate through the different markers within your project. And I've created a sample song just for us to work through, and it'll give you an idea of where the markers are in relation to each of those sections. And while I have a fairly standard song construct here, keep in mind as we go through the video series that you could have a Logic project that just contains a series of samples, and then you could mark those different samples within your marker track. And then ultimately what we're going to do is bounce down the audio file that we've created within Logic here, and we will take it forward and then use it within Mainstage, and we'll import that audio track into the playback plugin within Mainstage, and it can be used either as a backing track or simply as fills, or it could be used as a sample track also. And as you can see, the various markers are within the playback track within Mainstage right here. And I'll show you how we can navigate through these different markers. And while I'm doing this on screen, I've also created, and I'll show you how I've created a custom marker navigation box right here. And then I've mapped that box and the various buttons within it to an external MIDI controller. And in my case, it's an M-Audio keyboard. It could be anything. I'm also using a Behringer FCB 1010 foot controller as well. And we'll use that to play through either sequentially or go to direct locations of the track using markers. And I'll just play through some of this right now so you can get an idea. I'm just going to use my external keyboard. I'm going to press C5, which will cue up the play pause of the track. And I'll just use the same key just to pause that. At the same time, I can use different keys. I have my A4 and B4 key mapped on my M-Audio controller to go through and navigate to the next marker. As you can see here, I'm pressing my B4 key here, and it's skipping forward to the different markers that are located within the audio track that I'm using within the playback. And right here, I'm just using the back key. And at the same time, I have specific keys that are mapped so I can go directly to some of the markers within the audio track. And again, keep in mind, as I mentioned before, that while we're using a fairly traditional construct within our song here, these buttons could be mapped specifically to different samples. And this is a half-size pane. You could make this full-size and just continue to mark, create different boxes, and then map those boxes to different functions within your MIDI controller. So for example, here, I'll just go directly to a track. And again, I'm just pressing the different keys on my controller. I'm gonna start the playback, and then I'll skip around to various markers within the same audio file.
Boy.
And that'll just give you an idea of how I'm using the external MIDI controller to navigate through this. That's it. I hope you enjoy the upcoming series. Enjoy, and if there's any questions or comments, I'm happy to hear everyone's questions. Thanks.